What's going on, guys? Welcome back to NCAA Football 14, Road to Glory, and welcome to Conference Championship Week here in the senior season. The Bearcats will find out very shortly if we'll be playing for our second straight national championship, but of course this year we do win the American Conference for the fourth straight year. It's also our third straight year going 12-0 heading into the postseason or bowl season. But the first seven games of the year weren't too bad. You know, we had some competition here and there, but those last five games, I mean, you're talking about UCF, UConn, Temple, especially Temple, they almost ruined senior week. Rutgers and SMU all wanted to come away with upsets. They almost got them, but our defense and our offense pulled things through in the second half of those games and got those wins. But so far in the season, Trent Sauter, 4,100 yards, 33 touchdowns, 9 INTs. Buckley had 778 yards off of 180 carries for 9 touchdowns. Hodge had 73 tackles, Mike Tyson with 3 INTs, and Jamal West had 9 sacks. And Deontay Buckley will not play in whatever bowl game we play in because he's out 7 weeks with an injury. So, of course, the Bearcats won't play in a conference championship because there is no conference championship in the American Conference. But one game we will be paying very close attention to is the game between number 1 Ohio State and number 17 Michigan for the Big Ten Championship. This game did not go so well for Michigan the last time around. They lost 45-10. But the only way that we play for a national championship is if they upset Ohio State. And here's the Heisman top five in conference championship week as I lead the way. Jalen Overstreet at 2, Manny Stocker at 3, Brendan Nosevich at 4, and Joshua Mercer at 5. And here are the numbers receiving this year, and they're kind of all over the place. I mean, I had the same amount of receptions almost from last year, but the yardage is down. Touchdowns are way down, minus 15 from last year. The yards after the catch are kind of on par. Pretty good chance I'll break that career high in this upcoming bowl game. Drop passes are also up. So, I mean, it wasn't a bad season, but the rushing touchdowns, I got 2 this year. I had 4 my sophomore year. I didn't have any last year. But, I mean, 2 carries, 2 touchdowns, that's not too bad. Longest carry was 18 yards. I just feel like I didn't get the ball enough on the ground this year. I mean, I didn't fumble the ball at all. I had 3 broken tackles. It was a really good year for me on the ground. And also, blocking. I mean, look at this. 30 pancake blocks. One of the best blocking receivers in the country. I'm beating offensive linemen for pancake blocks, which is kind of funny. But of course, I also lead the NCAA in receiving yards with 2,400. Behind me, Kevin Smith with 1,449. But that will do it for conference championship week. On to bowl season we go, and the Bearcats will find out if we'll play in the national championship. And of course, whether or not I actually will win the Heisman. So we'll advance into bowl season. Ignore that Rose Bowl logo. We were supposed to play against Oregon in the Rose Bowl if nothing changes. So we'll move into bowl season, reevaluating impact players. And I come away with my third straight Heisman. And this voting was so close, 1,926 votes for me and Jalen Overstreet in a close second with 1,834. Manny Stocker finishing in third place, Nosevich in fourth, and Chad Kelly out of nowhere finishing in fifth place. So that's one more award for the shelf, one more trophy for my cabinet as I, of course, win the Heisman Memorial Trophy. I also win the Maxwell Award. Moving on, I also win the Walter Camp Award. I got it right this time, L. Taker. And the Biletnikoff and the Bearcats in 2016 will play for the national championship. Number 1 Texas and number 2 Cincinnati for this year's national championship. A rematch from our freshman season in the Fiesta Bowl. But the Bearcats will play in this national championship thanks to a Michigan upset over Ohio State. 28-21 the final score. And it looked like it was going to be all Ohio State after that first half. But look at this second half by Michigan. 14 points in the third, 14 in the fourth. And then just keeping Ohio State off the board in that second half until the fourth quarter. And just look at the scoring summary. Ohio State touchdown, 2 field goals. Okay, then Michigan comes out in the second half. Interception return for 57 yards. Then they put up a touchdown. That'll put them up 14-13. Ohio State responds with a touchdown in the fourth quarter. And then Michigan closes things out with a 71-yard run and a 48-yard run to put the game away. And this stat line, look at this. 8 first downs for Michigan, 240 yards on the ground, 6 out of 22 through the air for 49 yards, and both teams were horrible on third downs. The Buckeyes obviously had the more balanced offense. They had a good mix of run and pass, but I mean, it comes down to what I really think was the turnovers. Ohio State had 4, and Michigan only had 2. They had 2 fumbles on the Wolverine side, and Ohio State with 2 INTs and 2 fumbles, and that had to be what lost them the game. I mean, obviously, they ran back that interception for a touchdown, but outside of that, I mean, I just don't know how Michigan won this game. But diving a little deeper into the numbers, JT Barrett, 19-29, 221 through the air, 2 touchdowns, 2 INTs. He also ran for 11 yards on 21 carries. Wilson was 20 for 93. And Ezekiel Elliott, 7 carries, negative 2 yards. He actually got injured in this game. And then through the air, Smith led the way, 6 catches and 100 yards. Easily was 5 for 36 and a touchdown. So not a bad game for these Buckeyes receivers. But on the Michigan side of things, Shane Morris, 6 out of 22 for 49 yards and a touchdown, throwing 27%. But the ground game is where Michigan really won this game. Morris had 33 carries, Green had 104, Smith had 93, and then Shulman had 10. And you saw those long touchdowns by Green and Smith in the fourth quarter to put the game away. That's where these guys really played their game. And I mean, you look at the receiving numbers. Only one guy had more than 10 yards through the air. That's just crazy. But just look at this scoring difference. 45-10 Ohio State, and then 21-28 Michigan. The defense obviously played a factor in this game. But here are the bowl games. Finalized list this year for the bowl games. As the Bearcats will not play in the Rose Bowl, we'll be playing in the National Championship. What an exciting game. What an exciting end to a career, having the opportunity to go out as a senior and also win a national championship. So looking at the actual Rose Bowl this year is going to be Michigan and Arizona. So Michigan, the upset, the Rose Bowl, that's not too bad. And the BCS National Championship, the Bearcats will take on Texas. And like I said, this is a rematch from 2013 in the Fiesta Bowl. We did win that game. It was a complete blowout. And of course, the trophy is a little bigger this time around. We won 44-14 in that game. We were unranked heading into that game. We were 10-2, and I had, what, 7 catches, 4 touchdowns, and like 150 yards or something like that. But here are the award winners this year. I won the Maxwell Award. Obviously, I also win the Walter Camp Award. Got it right that time again. And the Bednarik Award goes to William Likely of the Maryland Terrapins. Moving on to the Nagurski Award, that's Ryan Cruz of Florida State. Neil Burchase wins the O'Brien Award. He aired us out in the final game of the year against SMU. He was great. And then the Walker Award goes to Joshua Mercer, who didn't end up on the Heisman Top 5 to end the season, but good for him. Blitnikoff Award, I also win this one as well, obviously. Mackey Award goes to Will Johnson of West Virginia. The Allen Award goes to Jay Guillermo. He also wins the Remington Award. And then moving on to the Lombardi Trophy. Ryan Cruz of Florida State. Ryan Anderson of Alabama wins the Best Linebacker Award. William Likely also wins the Thorpe Award. And then the Grozer Award goes to Sergio Scroca. Espinosa nowhere on the top 10 for this year. And then the Guy Award goes to Willie Muhammad of North Carolina. And the Best Returner Award goes to David Williams, halfback from South Carolina. And that, guys, will do it for the conference championship video. Hope you guys enjoyed. We are playing for another national championship. It just seems like they wanted us to be in this game. I mean, the upset by Michigan over Ohio State, just against all odds. There's no way that Michigan should have won that game. There's no way, but they somehow got the win, and we'll look for another big victory in a bowl game against Texas. And of course, they'll be looking for revenge from 2013. But thank you all for tuning in. Hope you enjoy it. The national championship will be up sometime next week. I want to say another Friday upload, maybe a Saturday upload, as we are one game away from the conclusion of this series. So we'll have the national championship, and then of course the off-season slash end of series video, as we'll go over career numbers and get ready for Madden 17. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you enjoyed. See you all next time. Have a nice day.